Hi, I'm Shawn with SparkFun Electronics, and I'm going to show you how to solder castellated vias. Castellated vias are a feature often found on modules made with PCBs. They come in a number of different names. You might have heard them as castellated through holes, or a castellated board, or even just castellations. I've got an example of a wireless module here, and a breakout board that fits that module, and I'm going to show you how to solder those two together. Let's see what castellations look like close up. You'll notice that this module has these little indentations along the edges. These are the castellations. When they make this module, they do it much in the same way you would for a normal printed circuit board. They would drill all of these holes and they would be normal vias. The board is then plated so that copper builds up on the inside of each of these vias. Then when the board is done, it is routed along the edges so that it slices off half of each of these vias, and all you're left with are these semicircles that have been plated with copper. Sometimes they put these square pads on the vias. This helps it wick up more solder and makes our job easier when we go to mount this module on the breakout board. You'll notice that the breakout board has these pads, which act as a footprint for the module, and it fits exactly on here. To start, you'll need a few tools. I recommend some sort of project mat, something you don't mind getting burned or cut. Ideally, it should be an ESD mat that's connected to ground of your building or your home. You'll obviously need a soldering iron. I like something with a changeable tip and something that you can adjust the temperature on. Optionally, you'll need something to clean your tip with. Tip thinner is a good thing to have, but it's optional. You can do it with solder as well. When your tip gets oxidized or dirty, you can just apply a little solder and clean it off. You'll also need either a brass sponge or a regular sponge that's been soaked in water. I recommend something like a third hand or a helping hand or something like a vise. You can put the board above the mat level, so if you need it closer to your eyes, those come in handy, but once again, that's optional. We won't really be using that. You're gonna need some solder, and I recommend something small in diameter. This is 0.021 of an inch. This is also water-soluble flux core, and it's lead-free. If you make a mistake, I recommend getting some wick, and I'll show you how to use this later. This is useful for taking solder up off of pads or bridged pins. You're going to need some sort of external flux, and this is where this flux pen comes in handy. Every time we melt solder, the flux inside of that solder burns off, and if you need to remelt that solder, you have to apply some sort of flux to it. So we need external flux in this case, and you notice that this is water-soluble flux, and it matches the core of the solder. Next, we need some tweezers. This is useful for holding the module. I also recommend having something sharp around if you need to cut off the used part of the solder wick. You can use scissors or an X-Acto blade, but diagonal cutters seem to do the job as well. Let's talk about cleaning your board. If you're using flux, specifically water-soluble or rosin flux, you really should clean it off your board. Water-soluble flux in particular can be nasty. I've seen it be corrosive, eat away at traces, solder, even PCBs if left on the board for some time. I've also noticed that water-soluble flux can be conductive, on the order of a few megaohms, and that's still enough to bring a line up or down and ruin your day if you're looking at signals. So, you should clean that stuff off. Water-soluble flux really recommends that you use something like hot, deionized, pressurized water, but in a pinch, our isopropyl alcohol will work, something you can just pick up at the pharmacy drugstore. And to do that, you just need a brush and a container. Pour the alcohol in the container, use a pretty stiff bristled brush like this acid brush. I've just cut the bristles down to about a quarter or half an inch. You wipe it in the alcohol, scrub it on your board, the flux comes off, and then use something like a Kim wipe here to clean it off. You can use a paper towel, but a lot of times they leave a little lint behind, so something like a low-lint task wiper will do the trick. You'll want to set up your tools so that they're easy to reach right in front of you. You don't want to have to be scrambling for your diagonal cutters when you need them right away. I recommend placing your soldering iron by your dominant hand or whichever hand you need to solder with so that when you go to grab it, it's right there and there's no cable crossing your body. Now, turn on your soldering iron and let it heat up. I recommend 700 degrees. That's what I usually use for soldering, but you can do plus or minus 50 degrees from that and you'll be okay. The first thing you'll need to do is clean your tip. If you ever see the tip become black, oxidized, or clumpy, you'll either need to apply some solder or you need to dunk it in some tip thinner. In this case, we're just going to apply some solder to the tip until it melts, and then we're going to scrape it across the brass sponge. The tip should come back nice, shiny, and silver. Repeat that process if there's any more clumps or oxidation until the tip is actually shiny. Next, we need to line up the module. You'll notice that there's a marking on this breakout board that says IC and crystal. On the module, there's an IC here and a crystal on this side. So spin it around until those two things line up. In this case, we have the crystal lined up with the crystal and the IC lined up with the IC marking. Since there's no designation for pin 1, we just pick an arbitrary pin on one of the corners. We're going to apply the iron first and then start feeding some solder into that joint to create a little mound of solder on one of the pins. I recommend always scraping the tip across your brass sponge or wet sponge whenever you are done. Since we've melted that solder and we're going to reheat it, you'll need to apply some flux. We're going to take our flux pen here, get some flux to come out, and go ahead and flux up that little mound of solder. Now we want to grab our tweezers, grab the module with those tweezers, move the module into place, making sure that your alignment is still correct. Apply the hot iron tip to the little mound of solder. It's going to melt, and then you're going to slide the module into place, making sure that the tip touches the castellated via. Twist the module so that all the pins line up to the pads, remove the iron, wait for the solder to solidify, and then remove the tweezers. At this point, you can go ahead and check to make sure that everything is lined up. Once you've soldered that first pin into place and ensured that the module is lined up with all the pads, we can go ahead and solder the rest of the pins. Take your tip and place it on the next pad. Move it just inside that castellated via, leaving a little bit of a gap. Let it heat up, and then we're going to apply solder to that joint. Once you have enough solder in there, I like to drag the tip away so that it makes a nice connection. Continue doing this for all of the pins. We're done with soldering the module to the board, but you might notice some flux residue left on it. This will be black spots or amber in appearance coating some of your joints or other areas of the board. We need to clean that off because, as I mentioned earlier, that could be corrosive or even conduct some electricity between pins that we really don't want it to. To do that, all we're going to do is just put some alcohol in a dish, and we're going to take our stiff bristled brush, soak up some of that alcohol, and proceed to scrub pretty roughly all of the joints that we soldered. Once you're finished, inspect your board to make sure that you've removed all of the flux residue and that your joints are nice and shiny and clean. Let's say you make a mistake and you accidentally solder two of the pins together. You have what's called a bridge solder joint. Fixing that is actually a pretty easy process. To do that, we're going to need some solder wick. Take your wick, and if you have used wick, which will be silver in appearance, you need to cut that off, as that can no longer wick up any more solder. You want to draw out a little bit more wick so that you have something to play with, and take your flux pen and flux up a good part of the wick. Wick already has flux built in it, but adding a little extra never hurt. Now, take the wick and place it on top of the bridge solder joint. Take your hot iron and place it on top of the wick, like so. Wait a few seconds and that should begin to soak up some of the solder. Remove the wick and the solder together, and the solder bridge should be fixed. If you notice that you took up too much solder on accident, you might want to redo those pins. To do that, I recommend always fluxing first if you have to remelt solder. Take some of your solder and your iron, heat the pin until the solder melts, and apply a little extra solder. Do that for both of the pins, or any pin that you took too much solder out of. Finally, take some of the alcohol, scrub again because we're using flux, inspect your board to make sure that you've removed all of the flux residue and that your joints are nice and shiny and clean. You're now ready to use the module in your project. I've noticed that these Castellated VIA modules are popular among RF manufacturers. For example, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, any number of wireless modules seem to come in this form factor. And it's really handy, especially if you know some layout, you can make a footprint that'll accept these modules in your project. And hopefully this has given you an idea of how to mount those modules to your project. Thanks for watching.